doing a bit?
You don't know, normally I do, but I don't have it on me right now.
I'll make sure to tell my hand on top.
Why, who are you kissing? If anybody's getting a minute to the room. Hey, man. Please rise in honor of the beautiful bride. Presents this woman to be married to this man.
I do.
Go ahead and give her a little kiss on the cheek and a hug, if you will. Michael, will you offer this fine gentleman their handshake for me? And now you may offer your arm to your beautiful bride, and both of you may step forward. And all of the guests may be seated. Take a deep breath for me now. Congratulations to you both. And as you know, you are here today to be joined together in marriage. And this is an act as ancient as the history of the human race. But it is still as new as each morning. And it speaks of the past and the future. The life of the individual and the existence of a community. Now, in presenting yourselves here today, you both are performing an act of faith, really, in each other. A faith that shall grow and mature and endure. What if you should have your love set in such faith? Not just for this moment, but in all the days ahead. I want you to ever cherish the hopes and the dreams that you now hold. I want you to stand fast in hope and confidence, believing in yourselves, but most importantly, believing in each other. In this spirit, you will create a partnership which will radiate to one another and give new hope and strength for any and all who see it. Now, if the two of you both wish to be united into this estate, will you please turn and face each other? And here, I'll take your flowers for you. And while holding on to your loved one's hands and looking into each other's eyes, Michael, I ask you the most important question of the day. Do you take this beautiful woman to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
And likewise, Sonia, do you take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
And now to seal that pledge, we proceed with the exchanging of vows. And Michael, you'll be first. You can please repeat after me. Don't be too nervous about that. I, Michael, take you, Sonia.
I, Michael, take you, Sonia.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I vow to love.
I vow to love.
To honor.
To honor.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
Completely and forever.
Completely and forever.
Sonia, will you repeat after me, please? Take your time. I, Sonia, take you, Michael.
I, Sonia, take you, Michael.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I vow to love.
I vow to love.
To honor.
To honor.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
Completely and forever.
Completely and forever.
And now may I have the rings, please? Just the rings. Yeah. Out of the box. We went through this. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Now, rings have naturally come to symbolize eternal love within the union of mind and body and spirit. And see, as circles, these rings have no beginning and no end. And that symbolizes the continuation of true love, an endless love that you both will always share. But also, these rings are made of precious metals, and like your love, they shall never fade. They will never tarnish. May these rings be a symbol of the promise that you both are making to one another, as well as a reminder of your mutual devotion. A love much like these rings. It's complete and beautiful and endless. Michael, will you take this ring and place it onto your bride's left hand? And while holding the ring there on her finger and looking into her eyes, I ask that you repeat after me once more. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Sonny, will you take this ring and place it onto your groom's left hand? And jam it on there good. Get it on there nice. And while holding the ring there on his finger and looking into his eyes, I ask that you repeat after me as well. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And now will you both join each other behind the candles that are lit upon the table? Go ahead and just walk directly behind there together. And I want you to go ahead and turn and face each other for this moment. Nice and close there. Pretend like you like each other. I want you to take this moment and think back. Try to remember the very first time when you both met. Seeing these happy thoughts there. These are the memories that mean the most. And they will last you forever. And they brought you here to this very spot. And these candles have both been lit to represent your lives as individuals. To this very moment. And they are two distinct lights. They're each capable of going their own separate ways, but today there must be a uniting of these two lights into one. So at the same time, will you each carefully take your own candle? And I want you to light the center candle together. And thus symbolizing your two lives joining into one flesh. Now go ahead and turn away and blow out your own candle. Go ahead and turn away and blow out your own. A little smoky, but this one light, it can never be divided. Just as your lives now shall never be divided. And may this one light radiate and continue to be a witness of your unity together. And for you as a couple, and for you as a family. You both may join each other once again in front. Close, you know the rules. Well, you two, if there is anything that you remember of this very moment, just always, always remember that it was love that brought you both together today. And it is only love which shall make it a glorious union. And by love in which your commitment shall endure, you now have what remains the most honorable title which may exist between a loving couple. And that's the title of living as one. And out of all of the hosts on earth, These two have come and have looked into each other's faces, and they've seen their uniqueness and their oneness. May you live faithfully together, performing the vow and covenant made between you, and may you ever remain in sympathy and understanding, living according to the ways of truth and beauty and love. Will everyone please rise? Well, inasmuch as you both have consented together in marriage today and have witnessed this consent before this company, you have each pledged your faith one to the other and have sealed this pledge with the exchanging of rings. Then by the authority vested in me by the state of Nevada, it is my honor to pronounce you as husband and wife. And Michael, you may kiss your wife. Now, I invite you both to start on your first dance together as husband and wife. Don't worry, Michael, I won't make you do it too long.
My lonely days are over.
To the world for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. McNamara.